Helen here with Eyes on the Game, and I'm here in Las Vegas. It is UFC 200 Fight Week, and I'm being joined by the one and only Superman, Dwight Howard. Good to see you here, and congratulations on signing with the Hawks.
Thank you. I'm very excited about first the fight that's coming up, UFC 200. You know, I've been waiting on this fight for the past year and a half, and I was looking forward to seeing Jon Jones and Cormier go back at it. But the greatest fighter ever, and Anderson Silva is going to fight. So I'm super excited about that, and I can't wait.
Yeah, so speaking of Anderson Silva and that fight, you know, it's last minute for him, and he was supposed to fight a few months ago, but had was pulled out due to sickness, gallbladder. How do you see that fight going with Daniel Cormier?
I love DC. He's a pretty good friend of mine, and I don't want to see him lose, but at the same time, I don't want to see Anderson lose. To me, he's kind of like the Michael Jordan of MMA, so it's going to be tough to really watch these fights and cheer.
And speaking of all the tough fights, the next event, the co-main, they have Brock Lesnar and Mark Hunt. What about that fight?
You got Brock, who's coming back. He's taking a lot of time off, and I think he's coming back with a vengeance. But he's fighting a guy who has a very powerful left hand. And if he catches you with that left hand, it doesn't matter who you are, how big you are, you're going to go to sleep. So I think it's going to be a great fight. I'm looking forward to whoever comes out on top. But I think if Lesnar takes it to the ground, he's going to win.
Now, are you a WWE fan as well? Like, have you been following Brock in the WWE?
I was a big WWE fan back in the day, but I have seen Brock fight, and I think he's one of the biggest guys in the history of life, you know, so it's great to see him fight again. I'm happy that he's finally healthy. I know he has some health issues, but, you know, anytime you see another athlete hurt themselves, you want nothing but the best, you know, so I'm happy for him.
And we have the main event, of course, of UFC 200. Now it is the women's bantamweight title fight between Miesha Tate and Amanda Nunes. What's your thoughts on that fight?
I think it's going to be a really good fight. Nunes is very tough. You know, she hits hard, and she's one of those girls who don't quit. So I love watching her fight. And then you got Miesha Tate, who shocked everybody. But her work ethic and how she's made it to the top is a true testimony of how hard work will pay off. Her fight against Holly Holm, she was in the fight the whole fight, and towards the end of the fight, everybody thought Holly was going to win. She ended up getting her in a rear naked choke and putting her to sleep, you know, so it was a tough one to watch, but, you know, I'm happy for her.
Now, speaking of the women's division and women's MMA growing, obviously you are a big fight fan. Who's your favorite fighter and also women's fighter?
My favorite fighter of all time has to be Anderson Silva. Like I said, I think he's the Michael Jordan of MMA. And then you have the Kobe Bryant of MMA is Jon Jones. So I really love MMA. I love the UFC, and, you know, back in the day, Rampage was my guy. I used to love watching him do the and then slamming guys, you know, so it was fun to see that. And for women, you know, you got Paige VanZant. You got the lady who's fighting in the two ladies who are fighting in the Ultimate Fighter Championship.
Claudia and Joanna.
Yes. I play with these ladies on the video game. And Claudia is just so strong. And then the other lady, her hands are just so fast. You know, I think it's going to be a great fight. And it seems like they genuinely hate each other, you know. So this fight is going to be amazing.
And also, you brought up Jon Jones, obviously, quote unquote, the Kobe Bryant of MMA. With the situation that kind of went on this week, do you have any words or advice to Jon?
Oh, man, you know, if I was to talk to Jon, you know, I would just say, despite what people may say or think, you know, I still think you're a great fighter, you know, and certain things happen, and I think people are going to be upset with him, and they're going to talk bad about him. I follow him on Instagram, and I think the stuff that he does is very inspirational. I think he's come a long way as a young man, and I wish him nothing but the best. And I actually saw the interview where he cried, and, you know, he showed a lot of humility, you know, on that stage by saying he would tell DC that he's sorry. And, you know, that took a lot of humility to do that, you know, because these two guys have been going at it. They've been jawing back and forth, fighting, making cartoons about each other. And, you know, here you have it where they can't fight each other. And instead of him, you know, being upset and not saying anything, the first thing he said is that he would tell DC that he's sorry. So, you know, I'm proud of him, and I know the situation is tough right now, but this will give him a good enough time to really focus in on himself and come back a better man and a better fighter.
And lastly, also what happened this week was the UFC 202 press conference. Conor McGregor and also Nate Diaz. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're fighting August 20th. What's your predictions or thought on that fight?
Well, we were actually on the plane, you know, with my team when we were looking at the Nate fight and the Conor fight. And everybody chose Conor. And I think Conor's one of the best fighters to ever fight. But he was fighting a very, very tough Nate Diaz. And what I was telling everybody who was watching the fight is, if Nate can take all these bombs that Conor is throwing, there is a chance that he will win this fight. And they said, no way, look at his face, he's getting beat up. I said, this Nate guy is a tough guy, and I love watching him fight. And he ended up winning the fight, and it was the most shocking thing that a lot of people have ever seen.
And was that, like, one of your favorite fights to watch, or which one stuck out to you the most in general?
Oh, man, a lot of the fights have been great. You know, I think Rory McDonald and Robbie Lawler's fight was really intense. You know, you had Robbie beating this guy up for a couple rounds, and he's demolishing him, messing up his face, nose, all that stuff. And then out of nowhere, Roy hits him with a solid punch. And now the whole fight is different. I think it's a kick. The whole fight is different. Then all of a sudden, he turns it around and hits him in the nose, and it's just like it dropped him, and that was it. So that was one of my favorite fights. And then almost all of Anderson Silva's fights were amazing. And the one that he fought where he was going backward and he caught him with a straight right and knocked him out, I'll never forget that.